So I first came across the idea of giving students true choice in the classroom because I was frustrated that my students weren't motivated, right? Raise your hand, kind of say, yes, that's me. If you have students that aren't engaged, that aren't motivated in class. And I read this book by Daniel Pink called Drive. It's a fantastic book. And he actually has a TED talk that's about 20 minutes long. It's kind of the cliff notes of the book. So if you don't want to read the whole book, you can watch the TED talk there. But the really cool thing about Drive is that he brings up all kinds of research and studies that actually go into what motivates us as human beings. And what he finds is that three things motivate us: autonomy, purpose, mastery, and choice involved in all of those things, which is why I'm giving you choice to kind of start this whole thing off. One of the stories that he told in there in the book is about Google. And Google had a policy where they gave their engineers 20% of their time. So a full day, right? 20% of their time, they're paying these engineers top dollar to come up with any ideas they wanted to. It wasn't dictated of what they should be working on. They were just inquiry, choice-based ideas, things that they're passionate about, interested in. And out of that 20% time, 50% of products originated from that 20% time. Things like Gmail, Google Earth, all kinds of Google products came from that 20% time. So I decided to do this in my classroom. It was right after winter break. I gave my students the project, was the 20% project like Google. I said, here's the deal. You haven't been motivated in class. We aren't engaged. I know there's so much stuff going on in your life. You're playing the game of school. Every single time I hand out a project, you're saying, how much is it worth? When's it due? If I hand it in late, what do I do for extra credit? All these different types of things. And so I handed this project and said, you know, I want you to learn something you're interested in, something you're passionate about. I want you to have fun, and I want you to learn for learning's sake. But when I did that, all of my students' heads just exploded because they had never been given the opportunity to actually learn what was going on in their own life, right? What they were passionate about. And so in this actual project, I gave students the ability to choose any single project that they found interesting. They could learn play guitar, they could build their own computer, they could learn sign language, all these stories. These are things that students actually did. But with that learning, the second step right there is making a product. So students must use the time, the genius hour time, the 20% time that you give them to actually create a product and put it into action. Students got on board and then they pitched to the class. So they kind of did a Shark Tank pitch to the class. If you ever watched Shark Tank, they gave four slides: what they were going to learn, what they were going to create, why they were going to learn it and why they were going to make it, how they were going to get there, right? What were the steps that were going to take them there? And then number four, which is really important, was how would they know it was a success, right? So then predicting, thinking about what the learning success would actually look like. After that, students had a chance to learn. They researched online. They reached out to experts. They did Skype interviews. They hopped on websites like Quora, which are huge question and answer communities. They watched YouTube videos. Whatever they were learning, they were soaking it up. And they were using technology as a tool to connect with people, to collaborate with people, to learn. At the same time, I also had them sharing. So this was a documentation of what they were learning and creating. And I shared as well. I blogged about it. I had a small blog at the time, maybe 100 monthly readers, which was my mom coming 99 times, my wife coming one time, just out of pity. And I actually got one post that I put out there that said the 20% project like Google. It got picked up by somebody that worked at Google, shared all over the internet. 10,000 people came and over 100 comments, everybody asking, how can we help your students? And so my students started interacting with different adults and experts in their fields to share, learn, and blog. And then they started making. They started making their project, whatever it was. And the final event that we did in Genius Hour in 20% time was a live streamed TED-style presentation. So every single thing that you just heard, from the project pitch to the learning that was going on, the research to the actual sharing, the blogging to the presentation, none of it was graded because I wanted them to be motivated to do it themselves. And when they heard that it was going to be a live stream presentation, man, it went up. There was competitive collaboration. They were so excited to share what they were learning and making with the world, and also nervous. And so that positive peer pressure just bubbled up until they started to actually work on their presentations. By the time we did the live stream and they shared it with the world, they shared it with our community, with parents, with other teachers, with other students, they had not only learned what they were interested in, and it had not only ramped up the engagement in the classroom, which we'll talk about a little bit later, but it had gone on to something that was beyond the class. They were actually interacting with the world. I get a lot of questions about Genius Hour and 20% Time, specifically, how are you actually hitting the standards? And so we were hitting the technology to actually research and hit all these different standards. We're using technology in the class, their own phones and computers and every different types of things to start analyzing and applying with the inquiry. We were hitting all different types of standards that were related to writing and presenting and creating and evaluating, right? These standards are built to have this documentation and creation and actual live pitches be part of what they were learning. We were even hitting some mathematical standards, and I was an English teacher. We were hitting constructing viable arguments, modeling with mathematics, all different types of things in the classroom. And we were hitting every single one of the ISTE standards for students, which brings us to our first challenge. The first person that finds the proposed new ISTE standards and posts a link in the chat. ISTE is kind of changing up the standards. They are proposing new versions of these standards. Post a link in the chat. You win free books. But we were hitting all these different standards as well. And we were hitting the four C's, right? We're hitting communication, collaboration, critical thinking, creativity, these skills that are needed, not just in the 21st century, but all time. And so what I learned as a teacher doing 20% Time and Genius Hour is that my job, I think they hit them. I think Chris and Elaine got them, and Christy. What I learned was my job was not to take all of my students to some end goal, but my job was to be the Sherpa, was to be the guide so that each one of my students got to climb their own mountain and reach their own goal. I'll leave you with this as we kind of go into engagement. We spend over 14,000 hours in school between kindergarten and graduation, K through 12. A lot of that time, students are just playing the game of school. If we can't find a time for students to have some choice in their learning, some inquiry, learning what they're interested in and passionate about, then what are we doing with all those hours? Truth number one that we'll talk about, every child deserves to own their learning. And what you'll see is technology empowers student ownership every single time.